saw you in that film, The Man Who Came to Earth, and that was a man who was in his own void, in
yes,
a way.
Yes, very much.
Do you feel that yourself?
Thematically, I've always dealt with isolation in everything I've written, I think. So it's something that triggers me off. It always makes me interested in a new project if it has anything to do with alienation or isolation.
Do you feel isolated, though?
Not really, but I can quite imagine how it must feel to be isolated. So I have often put myself in circumstances and in positions where I am isolated just so that I can write about it.
You know, in a way, I've sort of been thinking quite a lot about you and often seen you anyway, right?
Is this smoke bothering you?
No, it's not at all.
Good.
It's because we're going to make you that mysterious as you are that you've talked about. I think that it's not at all mystifying why you change your appearance as often as you do, to my view, by the way, because
yeah.
I think you've used yourself as a canvas.
Yes, very much so.
Is that right?
Yes, very much so. I never wanted to appear as myself on stage, ever, at any time, until recently, I think. So as I did write in character form, I wanted to produce those characters on stage, which is something I feel I did quite successfully at the time.
That was simply an exercise of projecting something else. Like you say, for instance, you would be presenting a picture.
Well, I was also... I wanted to use rock and roll in some way or other, and I got tired of the sort of... the lie of the rock performer is exactly the same on stage as he is off stage, which in most cases isn't true at all. But so I thought, well, take it a stage further and completely separate the personalities, the person behind it all who's writing it and creating it, and the one up front that does the interviews and does the shows, and so I created the characters and put them on stage, and then I would take them further and put them into interviews, and I would only do interviews as the character.
Were you hiding yourself from us?
Partly, but I was enjoying it very much. I mean, I like the idea of taking it to that sort of surreal stage.
Is that sort of, again, to carry on with it, right? Because you went to art school before you did anything else, didn't you?
Yes. As we all did. Everybody in rock and roll went to art school.
Right. And you paint now?
Yes.
But you paint things you're not willing to let us see yet?
No, I've been offered two or three showings, but I've accepted two of them, and then I broke my word and said I wouldn't show them. I haven't yet backed up the courage.
Why not? What do you fear?
Well, I know I'm a good writer. I'm not sure about putting my paintings in. They're very personal to me as well. They're all portraits, and they're all portraits of people in isolation. Most of the paintings are Germans or Turks who live in Berlin, and they're either from East Berlin and who are now living in West Berlin and knowing their families are on the other side of the war. And so I try to capture a lot of that kind of isolation. And I put a lot of myself into the paintings as well. They're very much part of me.
Mm. If you're interested in isolation, is it because you think that a person in an isolated state feels greater emotions than they do when they're surrounded by people and things?
I think if he is in isolation, instead of receiving the whole world as his home, he tends to create a micro world inside himself.
Mm.
And it's that peculiar part of the human mind that fascinates me about the small universes that can be created inside the mind.
Mm.
Some of them fairly schizophrenic and quite off the wall.
Does that mean you have to separate yourself quite a lot from, say, falling in love and getting very involved with a person?
I think quite the reverse. For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. No, I think love is very important for my writing.
But love, falling in love, is
yeah.
different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is, yes.
And once you love somebody
a
lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I would
really... No, I don't think so. I think you can love somebody from afar.
But if you then decided not to love them from afar, is what I mean, you as an artist would have to give up quite a lot of your time to them.
Yes, and I can't do that.
That's what I was wondering,
no,
whether you do that.
No, love can't get quite in my way because I feel I shelter myself from it incredibly.
What are you sheltering yourself again? I mean, sorry, I'm
losing that other eye.
Right, right. No, because you lost your that's partially that eye.
Yeah.
Over a fight.
Yes. Over a fight.
Within a fight. And what was the fight about?
Over this eye. No, it was.
No, it wasn't.
He wanted it, and I wanted it, but I kept it. Well, that was over. I think I can't remember it very well. It was over a girl. I can't remember her name.
Was it your first love then, David Bowie?
No, I wasn't even in love with her, I don't think. And he thought I was, and in a manner of speaking, but I wasn't in love with her. And so he came up and belted me one day.
But he and she's you've loved in your time, haven't you?
So I've read.
Well, I've only heard two, but it was you've been asked the question whether you're bisexual or not.
Too many times.
Yes, and you've never quite answered it.
Oh, I have. I said I was bisexual, that's enough.
Does that mean, though, that you really are, or does that mean that you're keeping some kind
I've answered the question.
Right, okay. Right. Can I ask you another question about yourself in isolation, partly? When you're now living in Japan, aren't you?
I just come back from Japan. I don't know where I'm going to next.
When you're living in a place, is that because you again want to be isolated?
Yes.
In a foreign place?
Yes, now, at the moment. It wasn't a couple of years ago. I wanted to put myself in dangerous situations, which I did. Put myself in any situation which I feel I can't cope with.
Dangerous situations,
yeah.
Such as what? Can you explain that?
Areas where I have to be in sort of social contact with people, which I'm not very good at doing.
I don't quite know what you mean now.
Well, I went to Los Angeles and I lived there for a couple of years, which is a city I really detest.
Yeah.
So I went to live there among people that I didn't like very much to see what would happen to my writing.
And then did you find you did detest the place?
Oh, quite twice as much as when I went there.
Well, what did you think you were going to detest about it before you got there? And
everything it represented.
Such as then what? I mean, that, do you dislike America?
No, I like the plains of America. I like New Mexico very much, and the Rio de Grande and around that area. But I don't like American cities too much. I like the real cities, like Chicago and Detroit.
I can't quite see what the difference between Los Angeles.
Well, it's sort of a callous. It's sort of a blister on the backside of humanity, really. Whereas Detroit has real people energetically trying to survive, but in Los Angeles it's fabrication. In real life, where I deal with fabrication in public, but my real life is not at all fabricated.
You know, and you said you do want to be in situations which you're frightened of, right?
Yes.
But how easy is it for you to mix, generally speaking, with people? Because surely you're so famous that people would recognise you straight away, and therefore...
No, they don't at all.
Really?
No, I have no problem with that, really.
But then perhaps is that because you do go deliberately to a new place?
Yes. That's why I went to Berlin when I left America. I wanted to have another kind of friction. And so I went to Berlin and I found the friction I wanted.
What was that?
People living under the impression that everything might collapse very quickly. And people are very serious there and don't care too much for flippancy. It's a very tight life there, surrounded by a wall with machine guns, which is ever coming in on you. The more you live there, the longer you live there, the more it comes in. And the wall, by the end, feels as though it's right around the apartment or house that you're staying in.
When you lived in Germany, did you get involved with people there? I mean, writers and artists?
Yes, some of the new wave bands and some of the serious writers there. I quite enjoy them very much. But most of the time I spent on my own.
When you went to Japan, which is not where you are now, right?
Yeah.
What was the... why there next?
Well, when I first started trying to bring pantomime into rock and roll, my other influence at the time, apart from German Expressionism, was Kabuki theatre. So, and from Kabuki, I then got interested in the cultural, religious aspects of Japan.
What do you find?
And the balance between the heritage of Japan and the modern world that they have and how they balance it, which is very precarious, to say the least. There's a friction there as well.
When you go to a place, I'm not a very good traveller myself. I resist it because if I can't speak the language, I don't feel I'm going to be able to communicate and so forth, and it sort of frightens me. When you go, what's the kind of first thing you get to know about a place in order to make you start to feel a little as if you belong to it?
Cafes and bars, I think, and where to buy food.
Yeah, right. you paint, and what painter do you think has influenced you?
Eric Heckel.
You've described yourself as a writer. What writers have influenced you?
William Burroughs.
Is he the only?
I might change my mind tomorrow, but if you're asking me immediately, those are the first things that come to mind.
Yes. And as a child, who do you think influenced you?
Donald Duck.
Was he your favourite character then, was he?
I loathed him. You made me learn how to hate.
You know, that's very odd. I've always hated Donald Duck. He sends me quite crackers when I hear him.
It's very unlikable.
Did you dislike Mickey Mouse as much?
Yes.
Did you like any of the traditional people that you were supposed to like? Like, did you like Winnie the Pooh?
No. No.
Rupert Bear?
No. No, I didn't.
Did you have a teddy bear?
No, I didn't. I don't think... I can't remember having anything like that at all. No, I never liked children's things very much. Mm. I always liked paintings from a very early age.
Mm. Thank you very, very much indeed for talking to me.
It's a pleasure.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Good.
Off, right?
Yes.
But how easy is it for you to mix, generally speaking, with people? Because surely you're so famous that people would recognise you straight away, and therefore...
No, they don't at all.
Really?
No, I have no problem with that, really.
Mm. But then perhaps is that because you do go deliberately to a new place?
Yes.
Yes.
That's why I went to Berlin when I left America. Mm. I wanted to have another kind of friction. And so I went to Berlin and I found the friction I wanted.
What was that?
People living under the impression that everything might collapse very quickly. And people are very serious there and don't care too much for flippancy. Mm. It's a very tight life there, surrounded by a wall with machine guns, which is ever coming in on you. Mm. The more you live there, the longer you live there, the more it comes in. And the wall, by the end, feels as though it's right around the apartment or house that you're staying in. Mm.
When you lived in Germany, did you get involved with people there? I mean, writers and artists?
Yes, some of the new wave bands and some of the serious writers there. I quite enjoy them very much. But most of the time I spent on my own.
Mm. When you went to Japan, which is now where you are now, right?
Yeah.
What was the... why there next?
Well, when I first started trying to bring pantomime into rock and roll, my other influence at the time, apart from German Expressionism, was Kabuki theatre. So, and from Kabuki, I then got interested in the cultural, religious aspects of Japan.
What do you find?
And the balance between the heritage of Japan and the modern world that they have and how they balance it, which is very precarious, to say the least. There's a friction there as well.
When you go to a place, I'm not a very good...
For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. I think love was very important for my writing.
But love, falling in love, is different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is, yes.
And once you love somebody a lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I
No,
really...
I don't think so. I think you can love somebody from afar.
But if you then decided not to love them from afar, is what I mean, you as an artist would have to give up quite a lot of your time to them.
Yes, and I can't do that.
That's what I was wondering, whether you do that.
No, love can't get quite in my way because I shelter myself from it incredibly.
What are you sheltering yourself again? I mean, sorry, I'm...
Losing that other eye.
Right. No, because you lost that eye.
Yeah.
Over a fight?
Yes. Over a fight?
Yeah, within a fight. In a fight. And what was the fight about?
Over the Zion. No, it was...
No, it wasn't.
He wanted it and I wanted it, but I kept it. Well, that was over, I think, I can't remember it very well. It was over a girl. I can't remember her name.
Was it your first love then, David Bowie?
No, I wasn't even in love with her, I don't think. And he thought I was, and in a manner of speaking, but I wasn't in love with her. And so he came up and belted me one day.
But he and she's you've loved in your time, haven't you?
So I've read.
Well, I've only heard two, but it was you've been asked the question whether you're bisexual or not.
Too many times.
Yes, and you've never quite answered it.
Oh, I have. I said I was bisexual, that's enough.
Does that mean, though, that you really are, or does...
Do interviews as the character.
Were you hiding yourself from us?
Partly, but I was enjoying it very much. I mean, I like the idea of taking it to that sort of surreal stage.
Is that sort of, again, to carry on with it, right? Because you went to art school before you did anything else, didn't you?
Yes. As we all did. Everybody in rock and roll went to art school.
Right. And you paint now.
Yes.
But you paint things you're not willing to let us see yet.
No, I've been offered two or three showings, but I've accepted two of them, and then I broke my word and said I wouldn't show them. I haven't yet backed up the courage.
Why not? What do you fear?
Well, I know I'm a good writer. I'm not sure about putting my paintings in. They're very personal to me as well. They're all portraits, and they're all portraits of people in isolation. Most of the paintings are Germans or Turks who live in Berlin, and they're either from East Berlin and who are now living in West Berlin and knowing their families are on the other side of the war. And so I try to capture a lot of that kind of isolation. And I put a lot of myself into the paintings as well. They're very much part of me.
If you're interested in isolation, is it because you think that a person in an isolated state feels greater emotions than they do when they're surrounded by people and things?
I think if he is in isolation, instead of receiving the whole world as his home, he tends to create a micro world inside himself. And it's that peculiar part of the human mind that fascinates me about the small universes that can be created inside the mind. Some of them fairly schizophrenic and quite off the wall.
Does that mean you have to separate yourself quite a lot from, say, falling in love and getting very involved with a person?
I think quite the reverse.
Does that mean that you're keeping some kind
of... I've answered the question.
Right, okay. Right. Can I ask you another question about yourself in isolation, partly? When you're now living in Japan, aren't you?
I just come back from Japan. I don't know where I'm going to next.
When you're living in a place, is that because you again want to be isolated?
Yes.
In a foreign place?
Not at the moment. It wasn't a couple of years ago. I wanted to put myself in dangerous situations, which I did. Put myself in any situation which I feel I can't cope with.
Dangerous situations, such as what? Can you explain that?
Areas where I have to be in sort of social contact with people, which I'm not very good at doing.
I don't quite know what you mean now.
Well, I went to Los Angeles and I lived there for a couple of years, which is a city I really detest.
Yeah.
So I went to live there among people that I didn't like very much to see what would happen to my writing.
And then did you find you did detest the place?
Oh, quite twice as much as when I went there.
Well, what did you think you were going to detest about it before you got there?
And everything it represented.
Such as then what? I mean, do you dislike America?
No, I like the plains of America. I like New Mexico very much, and the Rio de Grande and around that area. But I don't like American cities too much. I like the real cities, like Chicago and Detroit.
I can't quite see what the difference between Los Angeles...
Well, it's sort of a callus. It's sort of a blister on the backside of humanity, really. Whereas Detroit has real people energetically trying to survive. But in Los Angeles, it's fabrication. In real life, where I deal with fabrication in public, but my real life is not at all fabricated.
You know, you said you do want to be in situations which you're frightened of. You know, I saw you in that film, The Man Who Came to Earth. And that was a man who was in his own void, in
yes,
a way.
Yes, very much.
Do you feel that yourself?
Thematically, I've always dealt with isolation in everything I've written, I think. So it's something that triggers me off. It always makes me interested in a new project if it has anything to do with alienation or isolation.
Do you feel isolated, though?
Not really, but I can quite imagine how it must feel to be isolated. So I have often put myself in circumstances and in positions where I am isolated just so that I can write about it.
You know, in a way, I've sort of been thinking quite a lot about you and often seen you anyway, right?
Is this smoke bothering you?
No, it's not at all.
Good.
It's because I'm going to make you feel that mysterious as you are that you've talked about. I think that it's not at all mystifying why you change your appearance as often as you do, to my view, by the way, because
yeah.
I think you've used yourself as a canvas.
Yes, very much so.
Is that right?
Yes, very much so. I never wanted to appear as myself on stage, ever, at any time, until recently, I think. So as I did write in character form, I wanted to produce those characters on stage, which is something I feel I did quite successfully at the time.
That was simply an exercise of projecting something else. Like you say, for instance, you would be presenting a picture.
Well, I wanted to use rock and roll in some way or other, and I got tired of the sort of the lie of the rock performer is exactly the same on stage as he is off stage, which in most cases isn't true at all. But so I thought, well, take it a stage further and completely separate the personalities, the person behind it all who's writing it and creating it, and the one up front that does the interviews and does the shows. And so I created the characters and put them on stage, and then I would take them further and put them into interviews now it of me.
Mm. If you're interested in isolation, is it because you think that a person in an isolated state feels greater emotions than they do when they're surrounded by people and things?
I think if he is in isolation, instead of receiving the whole world as his home, he tends to create a micro world inside himself.
Mm.
And it's that peculiar part of the human mind that fascinates me about the small universes that can be created inside the mind.
Mm.
Some of them fairly schizophrenic and quite off the wall.
Does that mean you have to separate yourself quite a lot from, say, falling in love and getting very involved with a person?
I think quite the reverse.
Does that mean that you're keeping some kind
of... I've answered the question.
Right, okay. Right. Can I ask you another question about yourself in isolation, partly? When you're now living in Japan, aren't you?
I've just come back from Japan.
Mm.
I don't know where I'm going to next.
Mm. When you're living in a place, is that because you, again, want to be isolated?
Yes.
In a foreign place?
At the moment. It wasn't a couple of years ago. I wanted to put myself in dangerous situations, which I did. Put myself in any situation which I feel I can't cope with.
Dangerous situations,
yeah.
Such as what? Can you explain that?
Areas where I have to be in sort of social contact with people, which I'm not very good at doing.
I don't quite know what you mean now.
Well, I went to Los Angeles and I lived there for a couple of years, which is a city I really detest.
Yeah.
So I went to live there among people that I didn't like very much to see what would happen to my writing.
And then did you find you did detest the place?
Oh, quite twice as much as when I went there.
Well, what did you think you were going to detest about it before you got there? And
everything it represented.
Such as then what? I mean, do you dislike America?
No, I like the plains of America. I like New Mexico very much, and the Rio de Grande and around that area.
Mm.
But I don't like American cities too much. I like the real cities, like Chicago and Detroit.
Mm. I can't quite see what the difference between Los Angeles
Well, it's sort of a callus.
It's
a...
Right.
It's sort of a blister on the backside of humanity, really.
Mm.
Whereas Detroit has real people energetically trying to survive. But in Los Angeles, it's fabrication.
Mm.
In real life, where I deal with fabrication in public, but my real life is not at all fabricated.
Mm. You know, you said you do want to be in situations which you're frightened of. You know, I saw you in that film, The Man Who Came to Earth. And that was a man who was in his own void, in a way.
Yes, very much.
Do you feel that yourself? You were supposed to like... Like, did you like Winnie the Pooh?
No. No.
Rupert Bear?
No. No, I didn't.
Did you have a teddy bear?
No, I didn't. I don't think... I can't remember having anything like that at all. No, I never liked children's things very much. Mm. I always liked paintings from a very early age.
Mm. Thank you very, very much indeed for talking to me.
It's a pleasure.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Good.
Off, right?
Yes.
But how easy is it for you to mix, generally speaking, with people? Because surely you're so famous that people would recognise you straight away, and therefore...
No, they don't at all.
Really?
No, I have no problem with that, really.
Mm. But then, perhaps, is that because you do go deliberately to a new place?
Yes.
Yes.
That's why I went to Berlin when I left America. Mm. I wanted to have another kind of friction. And so I went to Berlin and I found the friction I wanted.
What was that?
People living under the impression that everything might collapse very quickly. And people are very serious there and don't care too much for flippancy. Mm. It's a very tight life there, surrounded by a wall with machine guns, which is ever coming in on you. Mm. The more you live there, the longer you live there, the more it comes in. And the wall, by the end, feels as though it's right around the apartment or house that you're staying in. Mm.
When you lived in Germany, did you get involved with people there? I mean, writers and artists?
Yes, some of the new wave bands and some of the serious writers there. I quite enjoy them very much. But most of the time I spent on my own.
Mm. When you went to Japan, which is not where you are now, right?
Yeah.
What was the... why there next?
Well, when I first started trying to bring pantomime into rock and roll, my other influence at the time, apart from German Expressionism, was Kabuki theatre. So, and from Kabuki, I then got interested in the cultural, religious aspects of Japan.
What do you find?
And the balance between the heritage of Japan and the modern world that they have, and how they balance it, which is very precarious, to say the least. There's a friction there as well.
When you go to a place, I'm not a very good...
For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. I think love was very important for my writing.
But love, falling in love, is different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is, yes.
And once you love somebody a lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I
No, I don't think so. I think you can love someone. I found the friction I wanted.
What was that?
People living under the impression that everything might collapse very quickly. And people are very serious there and don't care too much for flippancy. Mm. It's a very tight life there, surrounded by a wall with machine guns, which is ever coming in on you. Mm. The more you live there, the longer you live there, the more it comes in. And the wall, by the end, feels as though it's right around the apartment or house that you're staying in.
Mm. When you lived in Germany, did you get involved with people there? I mean, writers and artists?
Yes, some of the new wave bands and some of the serious writers there. I quite enjoy them very much. But most of the time I spent on my own. Mm.
When you went to Japan, which is not where you are now, right?
Yeah.
What was the... why there next?
Well, when I first started trying to bring pantomime into rock and roll, my other influence at the time, apart from German Expressionism, was Kabuki theatre. So, and from Kabuki, I then got interested in the cultural, religious aspects of Japan.
What do you find?
And the balance between the heritage of Japan and the modern world that they have, and how they balance it, which is very precarious, to say the least. There's a friction there as well.
When you go to a place, I'm not a very good...
For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. I think love was very important for my writing.
But... love, falling in love, is different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is, yes.
And once you love somebody a lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I
No, I don't think so. I think you can love somebody from afar.
But if you then decided not to love them from afar, is what I mean, you as an artist would have to give up quite a lot of your time to them.
Yes, and I can't do that.
That's what I was wondering, whether you do that.
No, love can't get quite in my way because I shelter myself from it incredibly.
What are you sheltering yourself again? I mean, sorry, I'm
losing that other eye.
Right. No, because you lost your that eye.
Yeah.
Over a fight.
Yes. Over a fight.
Yeah.
Within a fight.
In a fight. And what was the fight about?
Over this eye. No, it was.
No, it wasn't.
He wanted it, and I wanted it, but I kept it. Well, that was over. I think I can't remember it very well. It was over a girl. I can't remember her name.
Was it your first love then, David Bowie?
No, I wasn't even in love with her, I don't think. And he thought I was. And
yet?
No, I've been offered her two or three showings, but I've accepted two of them, and then I broke my word and said I wouldn't show them. I haven't yet backed up the courage.
Why not? What do you fear?
Well, I know I'm a good writer. I'm not sure about putting my paintings in. They're very personal to me as well. They're all portraits, and they're all portraits of people in isolation. Most of the paintings are Germans or Turks who live in Berlin, and they're either from East Berlin and who are now living in West Berlin and knowing their families are on the other side of the war. And so I try to capture a lot of that kind of isolation. And I put a lot of myself into the paintings as well. They're very much part of me.
Mm. If you're interested in isolation, is it because you think that a person in an isolated state feels greater emotions than they do when they're surrounded by people and things?
I think if he is in isolation, instead of receiving the whole world as his home, he tends to create a micro world inside himself. Mm. And it's that peculiar part of the human mind that fascinates me about the small universes that can be created inside the mind. Mm. Some of them fairly schizophrenic and quite off the wall.
Does that mean you have to separate yourself quite a lot from, say, falling in love and getting very involved with a person?
I think quite the reverse. For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. No, I think love was very important for my writing.
But love, falling in love, is different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is, yes.
And once you love somebody a lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I
No, really I don't think so. I think you can love somebody from afar.
But if you then decided not to love them from afar, is what I mean, you as an artist would have to give up quite a lot of your time to them.
Yes, and I can't do that.
That's what I was wondering, whether you do that.
No, love can't get quite in my way because I shelter myself from it incredibly.
What are you sheltering yourself again? I mean, sorry, I'm...
Losing that other eye.
Right. No, because you lost your... That eye.
Yeah.
Over a fight.
Yes. Over a fight.
Yeah.
Within a fight.
In a fight. And what was the fight about?
Over this eye. No, it was...
No, it wasn't.
He wanted it, and I wanted it, but I kept it. Well, that was over... I think... I can't remember it very well. It was over a girl. I can't remember her name.
Was it your first love, then, David Bowie?
No, I wasn't... No.
Rupert Bear?
No. No, I didn't.
Did you have a teddy bear?
No, I didn't. I don't think... I can't remember having anything like that at all. No, I never liked children's things very much. Mm. I always liked paintings from a very early age. Mm.
Thank you very, very much indeed for talking to me.
It's a pleasure.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Good.
Off, right?
Yes.
But how easy is it for you to mix, generally speaking, with people? Because surely you're so famous that people would recognise you straight away, and therefore...
No, they don't at all.
Really?
No, I have no problem with that, really.
Mm. But then, perhaps, is that because you do go deliberately to a new place?
Yes.
Yes.
That's why I went to Berlin when I left America. Mm. I wanted to have another kind of friction. And so I went to Berlin and I found the friction I wanted.
What was that?
people living under the impression that everything might collapse very quickly. And people are very serious there and don't care too much for flippancy.
Mm.
It's a very tight life there, surrounded by a wall with machine guns, which is ever coming in on you.
Mm.
The more you live there, the longer you live there, the more it comes in. And the wall, by the end, feels as though it's right around the apartment or house that you're staying in.
Mm. When you lived in Germany, did you get involved with people there? I mean, writers and artists?
Yes, some of the new wave bands and some of the serious writers there. I quite enjoy them very much. But most of the time I spent on my own.
Mm. When you went to Japan, which is not where you are now, right?
Yeah.
What was the... why there next?
Well, when I first started trying to bring pantomime into rock and roll, my other influence at the time, apart from German Expressionism, was Kabuki theatre. So, and from Kabuki, I then got interested in the cultural, religious aspects of Japan.
What do you find?
And the balance between the heritage of Japan and the modern world that they have, and how they balance it, which is very precarious, to say the least. There's a friction there as well.
When you go to a place, I'm not a very good...
For me, I do fall in love quite quickly. Once upon a time, I used to fall in love quite a lot. But I think love is very important for my writing.
But love, falling in love, is different from then going on to love that person.
Yes, it is. Yes.
And once you love somebody a lot, it means that you've got to share your life with them. That's what I
No, I don't think so. I think you can love somebody from afar.
But if you then decided not to love them,